we're gonna make a chicken Alfredo, and I'm gonna make a shrimp scampi.
Okay, so he's gonna make chicken Alfredo. All right.
Put some garlic. You got your butter, you got your garlic.
There's no garlic in Alfredo. So if you wanna school me, do the right thing. Today we are reacting to an Italian restaurant in New York who believes he can school all of us how to cook Italian food. To go through this video, I'm eating some confetti from Abruzzo. Confetti are almond covered in sugar, and they actually in these days they come in different flavors and they are so yummy. Hopefully they help me to go through this.
Okay people, it's school time, education time. For all you people out there that really don't know how to cook that well, I'm gonna teach you right now.
Amazing. I love when people teach how to cook. Okay, we got some butter there, okay. Lots of butter.
We're gonna make a chicken Alfredo, and I'm gonna make a shrimp scampi.
Okay, so he's gonna make chicken Alfredo, all right. I guess Alfredo is two ingredients, butter, which he used, and Parmigiano Reggiano. You guys wanna have chicken in America? All right, do it, what can I say? That's what you like, that's what you do. I'm not saying anything, you want chicken? You get chicken. I'm really trying to be good today, okay? Thanks for the confetti. Oh.
Put some garlic. You got your butter, you got your garlic.
There's no garlic in Alfredo. So if you want to school me, do the right thing.
On this one over here, we're going to take some olive oil. We're going to take some more garlic. No, yo, you don't got grilled chicken I want. Not that. Why do you keep giving me that chicken?
Oh. Well, that's how you speak in most restaurants, so that's the restaurant language, the kitchen restaurant language.
How you want to use it?
Oh, I didn't see it.
Okay. Oh, wow. This guy really loves garlic. Do you see how much garlic he used?
So, let's put the chicken in there, Donnie.
Okay. Look at that garlic there. It's already burned. Garlic cooks in 30 seconds. So, what I would suggest, when you want to cook garlic at high temperatures like now, you need to put some water, and that will avoid to burn the garlic.
Put that in there for me. I want that garlic with some color.
What am I gonna do with chicken like that? You can't put chicken like this on pasta. Come on, cut it into small pieces. Dice it, but not like this.
We got some chicken in there, okay? You see that? Can you give me eight shrimp?
To be honest, I don't miss the restaurant days. I don't miss the restaurant kitchen, to be honest.
We're gonna take some Italian parsley. Don't use curled, use Italian. Go in the grocery store, use Italian. We're gonna let this go.
I mean, the butter is really taking time to melt. I wonder why it's taking so long.
So, a lot of people, you can't buy it out there. You might have to buy lobster base. I make all my bases, so this is a chicken base right now. Not a chicken base, this is a shrimp base I'm putting in there. To give it some more taste.
Okay, so you're doing a shrimp Alfredo and chicken Alfredo. Okay, look, you want chicken? All right, but please, cut the chicken into those small pieces, dice it, small pieces, or like if you're cutting the guanciale. Come on, you can't eat. How can you have tagliatelle, fettuccine, whatever, and do like that with a piece of chicken like that? You can't have chicken and pasta on the same fork at the same time. You can't, come on.
So right now we're gonna put some heavy cream in there.
Ah, my gravy cream. You make the cream with Parmigiano. That's how you make Alfredo. I need another confetto. There's a blue confetto here. Let's see. I feel better now.
Heavy cream, please. Yeah. We're gonna hit it with some chicken base.
What? Chicken base. Where's that stock?
We're gonna put some heavy cream. Let that cook up.
I mean, honestly, is that pleasant to you guys? Please let me know, because I've never eaten this, and to me, it's not pleasant. I don't want to eat chicken like that with pasta, sorry. Some more pieces, maybe I'll think about it.
Then we're gonna put our pasta in there like that. Stir it up like that. Everybody take some grated cheese. Right there, nice handful.
When you put cheese, guys, it's very important. It's like a beginner thing. You know, if you work in a restaurant, you should know this. You never put the cheese when the pan is on the fire. In this case, it's on fire. If you put the cheese, it becomes stringy. You don't put cheese. Especially if you have a good quality cheese, you don't do that.
That's all it is, people. There's your chicken Alfredo. It doesn't get no better. Yeah, but it's a lot.
I don't like chicken Alfredo. I don't think nobody deserves, but if you really like it, cut the chicken into small pieces, okay? Cook it with butter, you don't need the garlic. Add the garlic later. The pasta to me looks pretty bad too. If you look at the pasta to me, it looks like it was pre-cooked 2 weeks ago. Doesn't look pretty at all. And use fresh pasta that takes 2 minutes to cook. Sorry, that pasta looks terrible to me. The actual pasta.
Not more, it's passion, it's love. Yeah, but I'm just trying to teach people at home how to cook.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, you know, you're out of town, you're way far away. You can't do this.
This is where
you can do it here.
Oh, look at that. Look at that sauce.
I'll show you.
Yeah, confetto, I'm sorry. Tonight I'm gonna have lots of confetti to feel better. That's a rock melon confetto.
I'll plate it for you guys. Show you how nice and creamy and tasty. It's gonna get no better.
800 New Loudoun Road at the Walmart.
Look at that. No separation.
A sloppy dish. Dish with no love. Now you have to put the parmigiano. Where is the love? Alfredo is butter and parmigiano. You combine the pasta water, butter, parmigiano, you emulsify everything. The ingredients have to make love together, and it's all about the emulsion. They're actually easier than this, too. Now, if you want protein, pasta has protein, parmigiano has protein. Have chicken later on as a main course.
You should know. Put a little grated cheese.
Yeah.
A little bit of thyme.
Alfredo has cream. Alfredo has...
You say thyme.
We're not in Italy, my friend. We're
this is better than Italy.
We're in the 5-8.
Better than Italy. Okay. All right. Okay.
Chicken Alfredo. Organic. Don't get no better.
American.
Now, we're gonna do some. It's not Americanized. Why you say Americanized? That's a time style.
No, it's Americanized. That's how you like it in America. That's okay. I understand. It's your taste. You like it? Fine. But do not say it's American. Alfredo is from Rome. It's made in a particular way. Now you're burning the garlic there. I don't believe Americans like to have burned garlic. Do you?
They can say whatever they want. They're weirdos.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna put some shrimp in there. Can you give me a lemon cut in half? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
At least he's using raw shrimps, which is nice.
No. Right. You don't need to peel it.
The garlic is way too burned. The garlic is way too burned.
No, I think you guys should mind your business. I'm trying to cook. It ain't your shirt, it's my shirt.
That's lovely, to put a lemon in there, yeah.
Look, there's a lot of people from out of state that don't know how to cook. Okay?
My friend, you're burning the garlic, that's what you're doing.
I'm gonna put a little wine in there. No cheap wine, but...
So far, I like it. Apart from the burnt garlic, everything is good.
So people, same thing as the chicken. If you were gonna do an Alfredo, butter, garlic, and shrimp, and then add the heavy cream and the grated cheese for a shrimp Alfredo.
Look, if you want to make an Alfredo with butter, parmigiano, and add shrimps, beautiful idea. But what I would do is I would actually give the shrimps, add the shrimps raw. What you will do, like, top restaurants, you chop up the shrimps. Like if you make a tartare, you mix it with some orange citrus, lemon zest, orange zest, some lime. You can combine ingredients, some extra virgin olive oil, and that can top up the Alfredo, which is made with butter and parmigiano. I'll give you a great idea. But when you start doing a dish like this, shrimps, chili, tomato paste, burnt garlic, olio, butter, that's not Alfredo anymore, I'm sorry. It's a beautiful dish, by the way. But call it whatever you want. Call it your names. Give it your name. It's a beautiful dish, by the way.
This is a scampi. It's got extra virgin olive oil in it, garlic. I'm gonna put some fresh basil in here.
Basil is not the right ingredients. I would say parsley or put some other herb that will go well with the shrimps. The basil is not the right one to go with the shrimps. I would say maybe mint. It really brings the beautiful flavors out. It combines very well with seafood. Mint and shrimps go very well together.
We're gonna put the pasta in there. You wanna put the pasta in there. You wanna get that off. Now
he loves to cook with a fire, the high flame.
Just to give it a little bit more taste, I put a little butter in here.
Well, butter is the original recipe they use for Alfredo. If you wanna go to Alfredo, you need butter and parmigiano. You put butter, a little bit of butter. It's not Alfredo, sorry. But by the way, it's a beautiful dish.
And that right there, there's some shrimp scampi. Oh, yeah. Forget about it.
It's a yummy dish, a dish I would love to eat. I like it. Apart from the burnt garlic, nice. And like I said, I would replace the basil with parsley or mint if you like to have try something new.
Now when you're done with this, put a little bit of grated cheese. And that's it. That's all she wrote.
Look, I know you want to put cheese, do whatever you want. It's your house. It's cooking for you for home. That's okay. Do whatever you want. But I think shrimps didn't put too much cheese. So it's okay. You can put cheese on seafood. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. But a dish like this, I don't think you need the parmigiano or the pecorino. Però, if that's what you want, you guys do it. I'm very calm today. Look, making confetti and I stay very, very calm. Very, very calm. Look, thanks to the confetti, I had a great time. Look, I have to say, the guy did a very good job with the second pasta. With the first pasta, it was not my type of pasta. I would definitely not call it Alfredo. I'm sure it pleases many of you. I would say try it again by chopping up the chicken. Make the chicken into small pieces. Like if you're cutting, I don't know, guanciale or, I don't know, just into strips or something. I think you will have a better experience because when you have the fork with the pasta, you twirl, you also have pieces of chicken. So when you put it in your mouth, you have a nice combination of flavors. Everything's together in your mouth. I'm just giving you an idea, okay? But if you like it like this, do whatever you want. I've got my confetti today and I feel very, very good. I understand what you like. I understand that's how you want to eat it. Okay, it's your home, do whatever you want. But if I go to a restaurant and I see something served like this and they charge me $20, $30, $15, $10, $5, sorry, you don't do that. Not in a restaurant. You understand? Guys, thank you so much for watching this. Would you guys go and eat at this restaurant after you watch this video? Let me know. This is how the kitchen works. It's busy, people scream, there's a fast way, direct, fast, sometimes rude way to talk to each other in the kitchen because the busy time in the kitchen goes for about 2 hours. When you have everyone coming to the restaurant, you have to serve everyone fast. So if you're not loud, direct, and sometimes rude, you don't get shit happened in the kitchen. The kitchen is, for those 2 hours of service, it's madness. And this was a proof, okay? Again, second dish, I would love to eat it right now. First dish, maybe not so much. Thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you on the next Vincenzo's Plate reaction video. E ora si mangia. Vincenzo's Plate. And please make Alfredo sauce with butter and parmigiano, no cream.